in the snow white. And we're going to have a special class today. But first, I have two friends who will be joining me. These are my woodland creature friends, Basil and Patchouli. They came to help us with story time and dance class today. Please say hello. Hey, I'm so excited you all are here to dance with me today. Are you ready for a fun time? Oh, good. Me too. Today, we are going to be reading my favorite story, Friends to Count On. Once upon a time, there lived a princess named Snow White. My wicked stepmother, the queen, dreaded that someday I would be more beautiful than she was. Every day, the queen asked her magic mirror, "Who is the fairest one of all?" And every day, the mirror replied, "You are." But one day, the mirror gave a different answer. "Snow White," it said. The queen was very upset. She ordered her royal huntsman to take me far into the woods. That way, the queen would be the most beautiful woman in the kingdom again. But the huntsman was nice. When they got to the forest, he told me that the queen didn't like me very much and wanted to hurt me. "Run and hide," he told me. So I ran and ran as quickly as I could into the woods. But the woods were scary. Branches seemed to reach for me and roots tripped me. I fell and buried my head in fear. In the morning, I woke up and lifted my head and saw friendly eyes of bunnies and deer, chipmunks, birds, raccoons, and my little guinea pig friends. I was so glad I wasn't alone anymore. "Please don't run away. I won't hurt you," I told them. I knew I could never return to the castle, but where would I go? Maybe the animals could help me, I thought. "I need a place to sleep at night," I told them. So the birds took my cape in their beaks and guided me forward. Soon, we came to a little cottage. "Oh, it's just like a dollhouse," I said. I peeked in the window. Nobody was home.
"Before you enter your cottage, Snow White, we have some friends that are going to dance with us today."
Oh, how exciting.
Maisie is so excited to see Snow White, and she wants to know, what dwarf is your best helper?
Oh, hello, Maisie. I'm so excited to dance with you, too. All the dwarves are great helpers, but I think the best has to be Happy, because he's always so happy to just help out whenever it's needed.
We also have Jill. She says hi, and she's so excited to watch.
Hello, Jill. I'm so happy you're here with us.
And Avery says hi from Leesburg.
Hello, Avery from Leesburg. Thank you for coming to dance with me today. Are you ready to continue our story? Let's see what happens in the cottage. I pushed the door open, and inside of the cottage was a mess. I counted the chairs at the table and decided that seven untidy children must live in the cottage. So I grabbed a broom. "We'll clean the house and surprise them," I told my animal friends. "And then maybe they'll let me stay." So I started to sweep, sweep, sweep and sing all the while. The raccoons washed clothes, the deer dusted, and the chipmunks tidied. In no time, the whole room was spotless. After the cleaning was done, I became curious about the rest of the cottage. "Let's see what's up the stairs," I told them. At the top of the stairs was a door. So I pushed it open and saw seven little beds, each with a name on them. Doc, Happy, Sneezy, Dopey, Grumpy, Bashful, and Sleepy. Such funny names for children. By then, I was starting to get quite sleepy myself. Oh, so I laid across three of the small beds and fell right to sleep. Before long, the owners of the cottage returned, and they weren't children at all. Do you know what they were? They were dwarves, not children. is clean, Duck exclaimed. Nervously, the dwarfs tiptoed up the stairs to their bedroom. They went in, and Duck slowly pulled away the blanket that had been covering him while I was sleeping. "Why, it's a girl!" he cried. "An angel," whispered Bashful. As I began to wake up, the nervous dwarfs hid. They peeked over the footboards. Sat up and caught sight of the dwarfs' faces. "Oh, you little men," I cried. "Now don't tell me who you are. Let me guess." And one by one, I guessed the name of every dwarf correctly on my first try. I told the dwarfs I had run away from the evil queen. "Send her away," Grumpy warned the other dwarfs. He was worried that the queen could use an evil spell on them. "But she won't find me here," I let them know. "I'll wash dishes and keep house and cook." The dwarfs imagined apple dumplings, gooseberry pies, and apple pies that I could make. "She stays," they agreed. That night, after a delicious dinner, the dwarfs and I sang and danced. "Are you going to have a dance party with me later?" So excited. The dwarfs had never had so much fun or laughed so hard. When we stopped singing and dancing, Sleepy turned to me and asked me to tell them a story. I told them about a princess who had fallen in love with a prince that she'd met at a wishing well. "Was it you?" they asked me. I nodded. My dearest wish was to see him again someday. In the morning, the dwarfs got ready to go to work in the mines. They were worried about leaving me at home alone, especially after what the queen had done. "I'll be all right," I let them know, and I kissed each of the dwarfs goodbye. "Could you blow a kiss with me?" "Good job." "I'm warning you, don't let nobody in the house," Grumpy ordered me. "Oh, Grumpy, you do care," I told him. Gave him a big kiss. He stomped away, pretending to be mad, but he had a goofy smile on his face. That afternoon, I forgot Grumpy's warning and allowed a poor old woman into the house. "Do we let strangers into the house?" "No, we never let strangers in the house." But I did, and do you know what happened? The woman gave me an apple. "Do we take food from strangers?" "No, we don't take food from strangers," she said. "Have a bite." So I took a bite of the apple, but I didn't know it was the evil queen in disguise. The fruit had been poisoned. That's why we never take food from strangers. I reached out, raised the apple to my lips, and I took a bite. To the floor. When the dwarfs returned to the house, they found me fast asleep and couldn't wake me up. I had a sleeping potion put on me. They had no way of knowing that the spell that the queen had used could be broken by love's first kiss. The dwarfs couldn't bear to lose me, so they put me in a beautiful glass bed in the woods where all of my animal friends could visit me. One day, a prince came by, the same prince I had fallen in love with by the wishing well. He gazed at me and knew that I was the princess he loved. He bent down and gave me a kiss, and slowly I awakened. The prince lifted me into his arms, and around me, the dwarves and all of my animal friends danced and hugged and jumped for joy.
"Hey, Snow White, we have a few more dancers that want to say hi to you."
"Okay."
"Juliana says hi."
"Hello, Juliana. So glad you're here to dance with us today."
"Emmy says that you look beautiful."
"Oh, thank you so much, Emmy. You look lovely as well."
"And she wants to know what type of animals are with you today."
"These are my guinea pig friends. This is Basil and Patchouli. They came to help me dance today and help teach class." I believe one little bit of the story before we get dancing. Goodbye, I told all my friends, and I kissed each of yours. I was leaving to marry my prince, but I knew that soon I would visit again and get to see all my good friends. The end. Did you like our story? I think our friends enjoyed our story and they're excited to come to class with us. Are you ready to dance? Oh, me too. Alright, our friends are gonna watch from right over here today. Maybe. We'll see. Alright, well everybody make sure you have plenty of room to dance. And we're gonna get started.
You have a glory, everyone.
Can you sing it to the wishing well? Good job.
Good job, everyone.
should we clean up first? Let's clean up all these apples.
Yeah.
to do. I'd love to spin his bow. Does anybody like to jump? Oh, I can't wait to jump too. Right, here's our silly little song. Okay, let's start with our spins. We're going to do three spin turns. Can you count to three with me? There we go. Christmas. Basil scrapped his grumpy face too. But that's okay, because guess what? All of your show me your happy pose? Nice happy poses. Good happy face. You all have wonderful smiles. I can't wait to see your happy faces. Right, but sometimes if we get on Zoom, we might be a little bashful, right? Can you look shy or bashful? It can be a little silly feeling, right? And that's okay. Because when you're feeling bashful, we can wave to our teachers, wave to our friends, and say hello. Sometimes, have you been feeling a little sneezy? Sometimes allergies creep up and we might sneeze. Achoo! Good job. Great. But what do we do after we sneeze if we sneeze in our hands? We wash, 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 and we can do our 20 spring points to wash our hands. Right. Oh, but sometimes after dance class, do you feel a little sleepy? Oh, and we can sleep. And sleep, have a nice long rest. Find a nice nap after dance class. Because your teachers do such a good job keeping you guys busy. Right, Basil's ready to go to sleep too. Julie, help me out. We have one more group. He can be a little silly. Is it sometimes to be a little, sometimes going to be a little silly? Of course, on the count of three, we can close our eyes and open them to make a silly face together. Ready? One, two, three. Oh, that was such a silly face. Good job. So sometimes if we're still feeling sad or grumpy that we're not able to come to the studio, we can just make a silly face. Can you make a silly face? One more. One, two, a magical time with all of you. Let's do one more dance together before we go. Julie and Basil want to also thank you so much for coming to dance with us today. They've had a wonderful time getting to see you. Okay.